Hello everyone. In this session we are going to see about solid modeling, which comes under the topic of geometric modeling. Solid models give designers a complete description of constructs, shape, surface, volume and density. So before this session we had seen about wireframe modeling, surface modeling and then surface entities, etc. So when comparing to that, solid modeling somewhat differs, which gives a detailed and a complete structures of a product or solids. So in CAD system there are number of representation schemes for solid modeling. So solid modeling representation schemes are primitive creation functions, constructive solid geometry, sweeping, boundary representation. So what are all these? Let us discuss about in detail. So primitive creation functions. So these functions retrieve a solid of a simple shape from among the primitive solids stored in the program in advance and create a solid of the same shape, but the size specified by the user. So this type of representation of solids uses a basic shapes and with the operations like extrude, revolve, loft, sweep, so a solid objects can be formed. So let us see some of the examples. So here the first one is nothing but a square is drawn in a 2D plane. So and it is extruded. On extruding this basic shape of square, we can able to get a cube. And in this example, we can see that a cylinder. So a cylinder is made with a circular in a 2D plane, and on extrusion, we can able to get cylinder. And in this example, we can see that revolve option. Like in a 2D plane, a triangle is drawn, and with the base, the revolve option is used to get a cone. Similarly, sphere. And these are the examples of loft. So here two planes are required. So in this plane a square is drawn and in this plane a line is drawn. On lofting we can able to get a wedge, and similarly torus in two planes two circles are drawn and a path is given so that we can able to get torus and through. Second one, loft option. Solid modeling techniques is nothing but constructive solid geometry. In the name itself it told that. So a solid of final end product is formed by constructive boolean operations. So constructive solid geometry is a method used in solid modeling for creating 3D models in CAD, and it permits a modeler to make complex surface by applying boolean operations. Boolean operations is nothing but, we can see that in these examples, A union B, A intersection B, A minus B, B minus A. The simplest solid objects utilized for the demonstration are called primitives. So in the previous slide we had seen that square, cylinder, torus, wedge, etc. So those are nothing but primitives, and these primitives are formed by basic shapes with some of the operations like extrude, revolve, loft, sweep, etc. The simplest solid objects utilized for the demonstration are called primitives. Classically, they are the items of simple shape like prisms, pyramids, spheres and cylinders. So in this case, this one is nothing but a rectangular block and this one is nothing but cylinder. So the operation A union B makes this product, and A intersection B, the common part in A and B will be the final end product. And in case of A minus B, in this A block, this cylinder block is subtracted so that this object only will be obtained as an end product. And B minus A, the cylinder, from the cylinder, the rectangular box is subtracted. So what are the primitives in this a rectangular block and the cylinder? So this is the representation in 2D and this is in 3D. So A union B, and then A intersection B, the common point, and then A minus B. From the block A, B is subtracted, and B minus E from the cylinder B, block A is subtracted. So what is the constructive solid geometry? Tree. It is defined as an inverted ordered by binary tree whose leaf nodes are primitives and interior nodes are regularized set operations. So the CSG tree can be obtained by the primitives and their operations. The creation of balanced, unbalanced or perfect CSG tree depends solely on the user and how he or she decomposes a solid into its primitives. So balanced, unbalanced and perfect CSG will be discussed in the next slide with a picturization. The general rule to create balanced tree is to start to build the model from an almost central position and branch out in two opposite direction or vice versa, which is nothing but like an physical balance. Your CSG tree is nothing but balanced CSG tree is somewhat like physical balance. So it should be equal in both the left hand side and the right hand side. Another useful rule is that symmetric objects can lead to perfect trees if they are decomposed properly, which is nothing but a solid, an end product is cut down into operations, and the operations is again cut down into basic shapes, which is nothing but primitives. So it should be both equal in left hand side and right hand side, and that type of representation is given as a perfect trees, CSG tree. So with an example, consider this an example. So B1, B2, B3, B4 are nothing but blocks. C1, C2, C3, C4 are cylinders. So these are all primitives which is obtained by extrude option with the basic shape of square and a circle. So balanced CSG tree will be like this. So CSG tree is cut down into operations. OP1, OP2 are nothing but operation 1, operation 2. From the operation 1, we can able to get objects. So object 1, object 2, object 3, object 4. Similarly, so a balanced CSG tree is nothing but we can see that the left hand side and then right hand side. So this is the CSG tree, and from this top down approach we can able to see that both the left hand side and right hand side are equal in operations and primitives. This is the example for balanced CSG tree. This is unbalanced CSG tree. So we can see that only one direction we are getting the primitives. So P1, P2, P3, P4, P7 up to P7 are nothing but primitives, and operations are OP1, OP2, OP3 like that. So a balanced tree is defined as a tree whose left and right subtrees have almost an equal number of nodes. Here what is meant by nodes? So 2n-1 leads to number of nodes, and n-1 leads to number of boolean operation, n leads to number of primitives, which is nothing but, so in the previous example of a block with the cylinder, so number of primitives will be 2. Block is obtained by extruding a square, and a cylinder is obtained by extruding a circle. So number of primitives will be 2, and A union B, A intersection B, A minus B, B minus A leads to a single end product of n-1, which is nothing but the two primitives leads to one end product, so which comes under by Boolean operation. And 2n-1 leads to number of nodes. A perfect tree is one whose nl minus nr is equal to 0, which is nothing but nl left hand side and nr right hand side leads to 0, which gives us a perfect CSG tree. Here is an example. Here the box 1 is obtained by extruding a square, and a box 2 is obtained by also another square or rectangle. So both the boxes leads to A union B. Consider this as a A and consider this as a B. And in case of hole in the object, consider this end product as A and hole as B. Here A minus B leads to this final end product. So these are all called primitives. And box 1 plus box 2 is nothing but Boolean operation. And this box minus hole is also an another Boolean operation which leads to the end product. Advantages of solid modeling. So memory required will be less. And in case of boundary representation, which is an another representation of solid, it requires more memory. So what is meant by boundary representation, we can see that in another video. Creation of fully valid geometrical solid model. So construction of solid models, final solid models, is easy. Complex shapes may be developed with the available set of primitives, which is nothing but complex shapes can be cut down into number of solids and again cut down into number of primitives, and so the complex shapes formation is somewhat easy in solid modeling, that too in constructive solid geometry. So less skill is enough. So formation of primitives is easy through basic shapes, and with the help of Boolean operation we can able to get solids easy to construct out of primitives and Boolean operations. So what are the limitations of solid modeling? New computational effort and time are essential wherever the model is to be shown in the screen. So it can be developed, and how it can be seen through the screen or presented through the screen. So for that, the computational effort and the time are more essential. So getting fillet, chamfer and taper in the model is very difficult. So in this constructive solid geometry, representation of solids, filleting operations, chamfer, taper, these are all operations. So it is somewhat difficult through this representation of solids. So this is another example. So constructive solid geometry uses primitives. So similarly, the square, cube and the cylinder. So A union B gives the end product A intersection B, the common area with the square box and the cylinder will be the end product A intersection B, and A minus B leads to somewhat differentiation. So the differentiated block B will be deleted. So what is meant by sweeping? Sweeping is nothing but another kind of representation of solids. So which is a planar closed domain is translated or revolved to form a solid. So when the planar domain is translated, the modeling activity is called translation sweeping, and in case of revolving, swinging or rotational sweeping. So this is the example for translation sweeping, and this is the example for revolving or rotational sweeping. So in a 2D plane, this T structure is drawn, and with the help of translation sweeping we will get this solid. And in case of the similar T shape, the axis is given, and with the help of axis this T is rotated. On rotational sweeping we will get this type of solid. So with this, the session is ended, and in the next video we will see about another solid representation, which is nothing but boundary representation. Thank you.